What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Got some exciting news here. We're in front of a bay door. Long story short, we had to move. I had to move headquarters, so I got a new shop. So without further ado, I have to open it.
Yes. Woot.
Hey.
You could fit like six cars in here.
Six cars? Don't be saying it's six cars. Okay. Yeah, six cars with no tools.
Okay, five. One, two, three, four.
What you mean two, three, four? You think each one of these squares can hold a car?
Yes.
No. No, I think we can get like, I think I could easily get three cars in here, able to work on them.
Work section.
Storage in the back and stuff I can pay for. Right here, I can have, you know, my toolboxes, my workbench, my engine stands. Man, I'm really excited. Never had anything like this. This is a lot better than working outside in a driveway.
It's cold outside right now.
Man, get them lights on. Get these lights work.
Oh, timer.
Dang. Wow. Let's close the door and see if we can see well.
Let me turn off my car real quick.
Here's how she's gonna look with the door closed and the lights off. Mind you, I haven't moved anything in here yet, but here she is. Hell yeah, I was just kidding. Got the babies up in here. Parts shelves right here. Parts galore. Got some trucks to work on here. Got this LT right here. I definitely am. I'm gonna get a hood light that clips on the hoods that I can have under hood lighting in here. This is how it looks whenever it's like dark outside. I can still see what I'm doing, but you know, it's not the best lit up. But I'm gonna be doing a complete motor swap on this LT and putting a 6.2 in it. Here's a C10. Working on it. I got one of the motor mounts on backwards, so the motor's sitting too far forward. That's basically as far back as it goes right now. And then I'm doing some work on this F body right here. But yeah, I got my hose out. It's a little bit of a mess like that, but pretty much this is for LS swap. You know, got my toolboxes here and stuff. Got my tools and stuff ready to work. So yeah, this is it, guys. Golly, I'm so excited.
This is the Jack Stand Builds headquarters.
This is it, guys. This is where all the new content is going to come out of. All the new, all the new builds, everything. And finally, got some indoors for this C10. Because, man, I'm ready to build this thing. I know y'all are ready for me to build it, too. It's about time. Got a lot of my parts here. Got my Terminator X, you know. Quite a few other things for the C10 here and there, you know, turbo stuff, heads and intakes and stuff. Got the intercooler up there. So, man, golly. I wouldn't be here without my beautiful fiance. God, dog. She definitely helped everything get lined up. I wouldn't have been able to find this place. I wouldn't have known where it was or anything. I'm still here in DFW. In Texas. So I wouldn't be here, you know, without her help. So I just want to give her a big shout out. Just you got to find the right one, you know, that pushes you in life, you know, pushes you to do greater things. It's an amazing thing, guys. But man, I'm ready to get this C10 done. You know, y'all are ready for me to get it done too. So without further ado, this is a new shop. I'm gonna roll a clip now of me working on the C10. I plan on making this a new video. So here it goes. What is up, guys? Welcome back to Jack Stand Builds. Welcome if you're new. Got my old short bed square body here. Still didn't come up with a name for it yet, but it's time to do that LS swap now. So
So I'm pulling the motor right now. Just drained all the coolant out of the radiator. I'm just gonna focus on getting this inline six with three on the tree out of here. Sucks that this thing's running right now, but we're making room for the turbo LS that's going in here. So I'm gonna start tearing this thing out, give y'all some progress as I'm doing it. All right, so here's where I'm at so far. I've got the stock harness pulled off of it, slowly just laying right here. Power steering lines are off, fuel hose disconnected. I got the radiator out and disconnected these heater hoses. And this is why my heater didn't work, I guess. This is where one of the heater hoses goes. Done did the starter, harness and all that. It was part of the main harness. So all that's really left with the engine is to pull the motor mount bolts now. So I'm gonna pull those bolts out and then undo the transmission cross member bolt, probably pull the cross member itself as well, pull the drive shaft. I undid the shifter already, so we're just gonna keep working at it here. Well, I'm about right here. It's actually been going a lot easier than expected. It's a lot easier to pull these motors out of these trucks, believe it or not. Plus, it's got such a small transmission in it. Leaking down there a little bit, but I'm trying to catch as much of it as I can. But about to start yanking forward on this thing. Honestly, I'm about to have this thing out of here, so let me keep jacking it up, and I'll set her out. So there we go. Now she's a roller. No engine or transmission in her. There's the old stuff right here. It's actually pretty small, but I think we're gonna take this color back to the original color that it was, which is this lighter blue color right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to prep this thing so I can rattle can it with some dupli color. I got it in the color it's supposed to be. So I'm just gonna see if I can just degrease it. Spray some thick old degreaser on there. I've got another kind too, that it's not just this foaming kind. So let's see what I can do with this. Reporting live from the Squarebody's engine bay, I'm your new engine, Aaron. Let's get this thing torquing. No, I'm kidding. So I'm working on these motor mounts right now. I just have to move them up. They made two holes up here that I have to move them up to, because these are like inline six location and I have to move it up to a V8 location. So right now I've already moved this one up to the V8 location. I'm just working on this one, so I'm sure you can see the difference. This one just has to go a little higher. It just goes to these two holes right above it, which they're right there. So just wanted to show y'all, I'm just removing the old bolts here, old crusty bolts. And There we go. I'm not using the right size. Everything on this truck is standard, but I'm using metric. One more right here, which is a pain to get to. So let me see if it's just as hard as the other side. The other side, I had to come around the back here and grab it up under it. There we go. Kind of slide my socket on there since it doesn't really fit properly. So basically, I'm going from, this is how it was, I'm going from these holes, that one right here, going from this one right here, and these two right here, to this one right here, and the two above it. So, just gonna move it, tighten it up, and we're about ready to start dropping this thing in. This is the strangest thing, guys. Remember, I was in there just swapping out those motor mounts, and then like I closed my eyes and then I opened them and I saw this. Crazy. It's just, I don't know how it ended up in there, you know what I mean? Like, I just don't know how this old carbureted big block got up in this freaking engine bay of this thing, but I guess I'm gonna run with it. But basically, I've got the ADE sitting on a jack right now. I've got a cross member for it. I'll get around to installing that cross member. But the motor's sitting in there. I've got the motor mounts on. And man, that's an exciting look right there. I'm pretty dang excited. I can't tell if it's just a little crooked or not. Maybe it's not. But either way, she's sitting in there nice and purty. Man, I can't wait to get this thing running. All right, so it's pretty cool that you can see it. See that cool little engine through this hole. What's that? What the heck is that? Oh, that's my cold air intake. Oh, my bad. Sorry, guys. Got confused. I thought I had a new alternator set up. Yeah, that's my cold air intake right there. This is the intake I'm going to be running. It's a Trailblazer or NNBS intake with some Edelbrock fuel rails. Got the valve covers on. This is all just mock-up. I don't have rocker arms on or anything like that, but yeah, no gaskets in between the cold air intake here either. So yeah, guys, I just wanted to see if it was gonna fit, but definitely is gonna fit, and it looks badass. I'm so excited to be whistling down the street. So keep y'all updated here once I start making some more progress.
All right, guys. Y'all saw some of the progress I made on the C10. Right now I've got the turbo mounted up a little bit. You know, just really the hot side. I don't have this V-band on right here, but it's pretty much mounted up. And then I got my intake on. Kind of looks like I'm not going to be able to run this water pump. Might have to get a LS1 water pump with some spacers. So yeah, I've made a little bit of progress here. Got my old trusty shovel holding her up here. Let me show y'all something here. I've got the transmission mounted up before I'll ADE. Let's see if I can get up on here and show y'all. Probably can't see it that well. It definitely can't, but you can see that crossmember kind of right there. And I've got the transmission bolted to it. So the transmission is bolted up. So really now, gotta put a few more things on. I wanna go ahead and start figuring out the radiator setup, and I'm gonna put the intercooler in there. But yeah, guys, I mean, I just, you know, made some pretty good progress on it. So without further ado, thank y'all for watching. Here's a new shop. You know, I've been working on stuff. You know, I've been working on the red ass body, working on the LT, and got the motor out of it and stuff. And so production's pretty good here. So I'm going to stay busy. We're going to keep working on this C10. We're going to get it wrapped up here pretty soon. It's about ready to get going here. So yeah, thanks for watching. Make sure to follow me on Instagram at JackStanBuilds. Like and subscribe. This channel's growing, about to hit 10,000 followers, subscribers. And I can't wait. It's gonna be a moment. So
it's gonna be a movie.
You know what I'm saying? Alright guys, thanks for watching. I'll check y'all later. Peace.